On this week's GTA 5 O'Clock, the first online heist revealed, Valentine's Day Massacre Pack and future DLC details, plus the alien egg, has it been found? Find out all this and more on today's GTA 5 O'Clock. Hello and welcome to this week's GTA 5 O'Clock. I am your host, James Jarvis, and I'm joined, as ever, by a well again, Dan Dawkins.
Hello, I'm well again.
He's well again. He missed the stream on Friday, which didn't happen, but he's back in the seat today for Wednesday. We've got loads coming up on the show this week. In a minute, we're going to talk about, yes, the possibility of seeing the first heist, actual working heist in GTA Online. We've got some news on the Valentine's Day Massacre Pack, which is coming out on Friday. We've got some alien egg footage.
Oh, yeah.
And some more stuff about future DLC and the Dangerous Business Pack. But first, let's get down to business and take a look at this supposed leaked heist gameplay that has surfaced on the internet on Tuesday night, Dan.
Yeah, well, first of all, a couple of people had tweeted at me, thanks to everyone who'd done that, and same with James, with what is in fact two separate videos of what looks like a legitimate online heist. Now, one of the videos is more like a sort of single player setting, but within the online world, and the other is like a four player take on the same online heist. Now, the heists themselves are kind of as you'd expect. They both take place in well, what this title calls the ornate bank heist. And it is in fact the bank we've shown you several times on the show in the past, where it's the one you can enter kind of up in, what, like North Los Santos, like the quite swishy area.
Yeah, it's one of the ones that you can just go in, you can find it in GTA Online, you can just wander in it, the door opens, you can have a look around. You can't get into the vault without glitching your way down there, but it is all there. It is probably one of the only interiors in GTA Online that is there, but nothing happens inside it. We should say we're not going to put the footage of this gameplay online because I have a feeling that Rockstar are going to take it down soon. So we're going to use screenshots, but if you want to see these videos in full, at the moment the links are still live, so you can click on the screen to go and have a look at them.
Yeah, no, actually, in terms of the structure of the online heist, I guess they're very predictable. As in, one mission shows you the four of you meet like the Jetsam, like industrial place. Mm. You get in a van, you drive together with the four of you, you arrive at the bank, you enter the bank. Now, it looks a bit like the AI is disabled or something isn't right, because you don't really face much active opposition.
No, compared to the trailer that we saw in the GTA Online trailer, which had snippets of this bank heist in it, that looked a lot more, you know, like there was a lot more resistance in it, there was a lot more security around, there were people inside the bank as well. Yeah. This is quite sparsely populated.
Incredibly so. And so you burst through the doors to no applause or no gunfire, really. And then there's like a giant yellow mission marker as soon as you arrive in. And then essentially you sort of like, well, I say fight, but because there's no fight, you sort of meander your way up the steps to where the vault is. And then when you get to the vault, you have to perform like a rudimentary hacking mission.
Yeah, we've seen this kind of hacking thing before. I think when GTA Online first launched, there was a mission where you had to go and steal some high-value cars from a mansion. It might have even been the Playboy-esque mansion. I can't quite remember. And on that, you had to use a hacking thing on your phone by launching the hacking software and doing some like a rudimentary mini-game. It didn't quite work when I played it. There were some issues with it, but it seems in this it's back and you have to hack a terminal using some aptly named Rockstar, you know, backdoor hacking software.
Yeah. It's the software you've seen elsewhere in the game, so it is that side of it is legit, really, isn't it?
Yeah, I think the thing that we have issue with about this, the way that this is working, is it seems to be a modded version of GTA Online hosted on a local server, so it's not actually connected as such to the internet. And I think the way that it's been modded is the mission markers might be in a different place, some of the AI isn't there, a lot of the other environmental effects probably aren't in there, so it's not, this isn't how the heist will look in the game. It's a rough representation of it maybe, but it definitely will be a lot different to this once you first see it when it actually comes out on GTA Online.
Yeah, it's getting increasingly hard to sort of separate fact from fiction in the GTA community because of the fact that the game's been sort of decompiled and hacked. And we saw that, like, you know, you know, I can't believe it's true sort of tsunami mod last week, which again, you know, you can't believe that's running on PS3. What have they done? Have they raised the water level? It looks really weird. It's almost like you've entered this matrix, you know, you're not sure what's real and what isn't. And this again looks like, you know, someone's legitimately accessed like a DNS server to, you know, get onto a portion of the game that is playable online. It happens to be online heist, but have they manipulated themselves to make it look more legitimate? Have they created, because one sort of telltale thing a few people have picked up on is the footage says, like, you know, at the bottom it goes, protect the enterants, not the entrance, the enterants. So either Rockstar have forgotten how to spell,
is it suddenly forgotten?
Yeah, or, you know, or it's such an early version, it was left like that. What we do know is that, again, from our discussions on previous episodes about the GTA 5 bug log files, which you can catch up with, it talks about all the different stages the game went through and all the different bug logs and the way the testers went through it. Now, there is reference to like multiplayer heists, as you know, as long ago as over 2 years ago. So this isn't a new concept. And, you know, to be completely frank, Rockstar have not only shown us teaser footage of an online heist, they have repeated again in yesterday's communication about the Valentine's Day stuff that there are going to be online heists. So literally, there are going to be online heists.
Yeah.
And this is likely the location because they've already literally shown it to us. Now, whether this, you know, as it appears in that leak footage, is exactly how it plays out, I doubt. I think it'll be a bit more involved, more complex, a bit more fun.
Yeah, I think so. There's footage of him going into the vault, which you have to hack open in the same way again. You go round into the vault. There's like a guard in one of the videos who just stands there and then gets shot. And then you go and pick up, not cash, it's a, like an actual gold bar, which you retrieve. And then you have to, assume, fight your way out back out the bank. But again, because it's a modded version of the online thing, you don't really fight your way back out. You sort of walk out.
And then you get in like a sort of Scooby-Doo style van and drive away. And then you've got to like go back to Leicester's warehouse.
Yeah, which would make sense that these were Leicester missions, because we know Leicester organises the heists in the single player game, or is definitely a big part of that. So you would be doing them for him, you'd think. Why Leicester wants loads and loads of money and is doing this, you know, just off the cuff, not really sure, but it seems to fit into the universe, it being a Leicester mission.
And you'd want really in real life, when the online heist eventually comes, them to be a much closer mimic of the single player game, as in to be more bombastic, to offer you options in terms of like preparation and approach.
Yeah,
because as a team you might go, we're going to do this stealthy and we're going to get all this kit together, and that would be really fun. It might even be fun if you were competing with another team to get the assets for a certain approach.
Yeah,
now that might be more interesting, because then you could play it as a series of like almost like a playlist of heist missions,
like
against
each
other.
Like who's going to get the van, and then who's going to get the weapons first. And if you're competing with a different heist team, maybe like you're left with the pistols and they've got all the rocket launchers, but you've got the supercar, so they have to get away in like a toy truck or something.
So I think there's ways to make it much more interesting than this leak currently appears. You know, is it coming? Yes.
Yeah, I think it's worth mentioning at the end of it, in these modded versions where you don't actually get any money, whether that's because it's a modded thing or not, I have seen some people saying that you get the money a bit like in single player, you get given it like 20 minutes later, like I guess as if we were if we were doing it as a main mission, you'd say once I've, you know, got rid of this or melted it down, then I'll distribute it between the people who did it. So allegedly it's an $80,000 split, depending on who's in the, how many people you do it with. So you could get 80 grand on your own and not split it with your crew, or you could split it between like four of you. That seems like a reasonable amount of money, considering that you get maybe $1,000 or $2,000 for doing a normal race or winning a race in GTA Online. That's quite a considerable chunk. You'd only have to do, you know, five or six of them, and you've got a huge amount of money. So that's the GTA Online heists. Moving on then, Dan, as you mentioned just then, Rockstar did release a thing on the Newswire yesterday about the Valentine's Day Massacre special, which is coming this Friday, to celebrate all the things that we love, which is 60s style hats, cars, and new guns.
It's actually more 1920s, sort of like the sort of classic days of Prohibition, gangsterism, More like a sort of, you know, like the mafia games almost. And you've got like guys and dolls, girls in the dresses.
Dancing, you can't see that.
That and it does, you know, in outlines there's a couple of new things it brings for a limited time period only. One is a new weapon called the Gutenberg Sweeper. And it's basically like a Tommy gun.
Mm-hmm.
It looks really exciting. So you get it from any ammunition in GTA Online. And in story mode, you also get it, and it's automatically deposited into each character's weapon inventory with free 2 full clips. It's just like the Razor model for Gillette. You get 2 free clips. You have to buy the rest from ammunition.
Yeah.
Damn you, Rockstar. Then there's a new vehicle called the Albany Roosevelt, which is a classic sort of gangster-style 1920s limousine.
That looks pretty cool.
Yeah, it looks really nice.
It's armoured as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it's armoured. And what's great, it says, you can get in the driver's seat and let your friends or crewmates hang off the side, firing and taking out rivals as you pass by.
That's nice. That's because we haven't had any vehicles in GTA Online yet that let you have crew members sort of hanging off the side. Everyone has to be inside.
Mm.
But, you know, I mean, they're more vulnerable to get shot hanging off the side, but it'd be a nice thing to drive around with, like, 4 people.
Isn't that an interesting thing? Because going back to over a year ago in the show, when we were speculating on some of the pursuit screenshots Rockstar had released, there were a lot of like police SWAT vans with, you know, what looked like police hanging off the side.
Yeah.
Which I can't remember as being much of a thing in the final game. Maybe because I was so good at avoiding the police.
Yeah, maybe you shot them all before they could hang off the side. No, I don't think it featured that much. I think, and you do get SWAT guys in. I have seen them in online, I think, coming in, holding onto the side of the vehicles, but it's not as prominent as possibly we anticipated.
Well, if you want the Albany Roosevelt, it's available from any garage. It says from any garage property in story mode, and it's available in GTA Online from the legendarymotorsport.net website. Now, you also get new clothes. Yes, new clothes. It says dressed to the nines in a host of new double-breasted suits and 1920s flapper dresses. This is the bit that I had a double take at. It says, or bear it all in sexy undergarments while going incognito with a selection of new masquerade masks.
Nice.
So is that like, you know, bras, pants and clown mask on a stick?
Well, if it's 1920s, you'd think they'd have some new lady undergarments that are probably all a bit sexy.
Sexy.
Because there's even a new lady haircut, isn't there? Like the 1920s bob cut.
Yeah, there's a flapper bob hairstyle exclusively for the ladies.
Nice.
Now there's new novelty t-shirts, hats, and more available in stores through Los Santos. And then finally, this is the sort of substantial bit, there's 10 new jobs. It says the Valentine's Day Massacre includes 10 new jobs scattered like the remnants of a broken heart throughout the world of GTA Online, including death matches, a new parachute jump, and a new land, sea, and cycling races.
That's good. So for more of this Valentine's Day stuff, we will be featuring it, hopefully, if it's live in time, in the GT Online live stream that we're doing on Friday at 4 p.m. So get involved in one of our crews. We've got the GTA oclock crew, the GTA oclock shadows, and the GTA oclock gravels. You'll find them on the Rockstar Social Club. Our member limit has been upped to 1,000.
So it's up to 3,000 people across the 3 crews now can take part.
Yeah. Now, last week, I think there were some issues with accepting all of those new people.
A lot
of the Rockstar Social Club was bringing back an error message when we tried to accept them. So if you have sent one in the past, I think the best thing to do is resend that request, and then we can hopefully accept it and bulk up our numbers. And then we should see you all online on Friday. But there was one extra thing, Dan, in the post on the Rockstar Newswire about future DLC.
Yeah, it says we'll have more information soon for other forthcoming GTA Online content updates, including, and this is the big thing, the Dangerous Business Pack.
Mm.
So that's the unveiling of a new name for a pack. It does also say Dangerous Business Pack, online heists, as we just discussed, and an expansion to the creator tool. But I think what we're interested in is the Dangerous Business Pack. I guess, you know, my first thought would be that's a pretty broad setting.
Yeah.
But then the word business implies it's either some kind of like legitimate businessman tip of the hat where you are on the surface performing normal activities but are in fact engaged in nefarious ones.
Mm.
But we think it might be linked to something else that's doing the rounds.
Yeah, we've seen some screenshots of a website which features a lot of mansions. Now, these are mansions that you don't see in the game at all. Oh, they're not in the single-player game. You don't visit them. But they seem to be tied in to a side mission that you do for a real estate agent, which you've played, Dan.
Now, what it is, if you go in GTA Online, if you access the internet, you can get on a website which is like Lenny Avery Realty, or whatever it is, you know, like real estate. And that contains, it's like a website that's under construction, but you can access it also in single player. And in single player, it's a bit more built out, and there's like images of mansions that don't really, you don't have any interaction with in the game. Now, also, because as I say, all bets are off and the game's being decompiled and hacked and images are being stripped out, there is videos of people who claim to have like taken apart the file structure and said these are these different visuals and icons that relate to Lenny Avery. And in that, there's like sort of eight or so big mansions, which are, like say, compared to what we've had previously in GTA Online, which is simply largely generic apartments contained within larger buildings. These are proper full-blown mansions with exteriors and much more unique looks. They're much more player and exciting and cool. Lenny Avery doesn't really appear that much in the single player, but you do interact a lot if you play as Trevor with a guy called Josh Bernstein, who's Lenny Avery's old like real estate partner who, you know, bummed him over. So what happens is Trevor teams up with Josh to shoot all of Lenny Avery's real estate signs, and like Trevor's reward is, well, basically getting to sleep with a woman who, it turns out, is, spoiler alert, Josh Bernstein's own wife. So he's a bit of a buffoon, Josh Bernstein. And like in the canon ending, like, you basically do kill him after he tries to betray you. But yeah, Lenny Avery, he appears briefly, you threaten him, you say to leave Josh alone. Lenny could be coming back, he could be trying to sell you properties in GTA Online. It sounds, again, very plausible and likely. And you'd expect there to be expansions in that, because it is a bit disappointing at the moment.
It would all hint towards that they are coming in some form, whether you buy them as a business or run a business from them, or you buy them just to live in once you've, you know, made loads of money and then you're like, you know, I'll come up to my mansion, don't bother with the apartments anymore. We shall see. One other bit, which sort of ties into the dangerous business stuff as well, is a long time ago we discussed a leaked sound, like audio clips that were doing the rounds on online. And these contain phrases from Martin in the game, who talks about getting money into property and things like that, and using that kind of stuff to make yourself money that way. So that could be tied into a sort of dangerous business. Have you got some quotes there?
Yeah, one is Martin says, "My friend, you should really get some money heating in property." Heating in property? Is that madness? Or is that a typo?
I guess he means like heating up, like, I don't know.
Anyway, Martin also says, "Take a look around and buy something." Then he says, "We will earn plenty of money, my friend. We have to get going in this life. Invest your money."
Yeah.
He also says, "How do you share in a property to buy merchandise from?" And then other things say, like, "Martin, my friend, perhaps it is time for you to invest in some serious business opportunities." Which, again, the word business, dangerous business, there seems to be an overlap.
Yeah.
Martin also says, "There are properties all over Los Santos that return income." Then Martin says, "We'll need a retail operation." So there's all these sort of things that feel property investment linked.
Yeah.
With all of this now, I feel like, you know, it's just jigsaw pieces coming together. You've got the website that exists online and offline. You've got the guy who's hacked the files apart. You've got this old audio leak. You've got the fact it's called dangerous business. You know, it's maybe 2 and 2 equal 5, but it just feels like it's all slotting into place. Now, also in that leaked audio, it's worth mentioning that there were references to, as you know, as discussed previously, pink slips for betting and for races, a casino finally opening up, loads of quotes relating to that, talks of arms deals, drug hustling, and there's a lot of talk of that, of like running drugs back and forth in missions like that. And then it says one about sending special attackers to players via Leicester, player spying, the new camera phone upgrade, which could even be what we've got already.
Yeah, it could be the new filters we've got, or possibly new modes like recording stuff and things like that. We shall see. If this dangerous business pack comes out and there is stuff from Martin in there, and some of these quotes are in there word for word or slightly tweaked versions of them, it almost guarantees that the rest of that audio file is also... legitimate.
Yeah.
So you can expect that all of those pink slips and the casino and all of that stuff will happen. probably not in the same pack. Possibly, I mean, it could happen in the same pack. That'd be quite a massive update. But we shall see. Once that DLC launches, it'll give us a much clearer idea of what's to come and the future plans for GTA Online.
Yeah, I think what set everyone back is the fact that essentially Rockstar probably didn't anticipate the scale of the hacking, money problems, RP boosting, all the stuff that's happened. They've got a full-time job probably just trying to neutralise what they've got. Mm. And all the time that's happening, it's probably taking resource away from building the stuff they always intended to make. Hey, what's happening with GTA 5 on PC? All those other things. What about this significant single-player DLC we know is coming? You know, all that stuff's got to get worked on while other people just keep the plates spinning on GTA Online.
Yeah. All right, so that's the Valentine's Day special and DLC packs. Moving on to our final thing of the week this week, and it's alien.
Yeah.
And it's egg-shaped.
Yeah.
The alien egg, potentially, well, here's an image of it on screen. This is possibly what it looks like. Again, we've talked a lot about the hacking and pulling apart the game files. This has come from that. Someone has managed to pull out a texture model from the game files, make it into a 3D shape, and then put that 3D shape, mod that into the game, and take a screenshot of it, which is what you can see here. Whether or not this is an actual piece of, like, a prop from the game, or it's something that was going to be in a mission which has now been cut, or it's a thing that is already in the game but is, like, disguised in a different thing. I think I've seen images of this egg-shaped like thing being in the UFO that Michael gets abducted into when the aliens are, like, operating on him. When you look up, there's, like, an egg-shaped ball which is sort of green and glowing. So it could be used as part of the prop for that scene. People are still looking for it. The fact, I think, is that it being in the game, well, the texture model being in the game, possibly means that it is in the game, but equally it could be a cut thing.
I wonder if it's similar to the, you remember the alien HUD that got leaked?
Yeah.
People were saying it was like the UFO user interface. Mm. But, you know, all I understand is that maybe that was from something else. And, you know, the egg might be part of that sort of thing, deleted scene or something like that.
Yeah.
So we don't know. I mean, it could even be that someone is clever enough, you know, if you can raise the water levels. I feel like maybe someone in a thread did say what they've done is remove the Jimmy character model and replaced it with an egg. I don't know if that was a joke or if they actually have replaced the Jimmy model and texture with, like, a giant glowing alien egg.
Right.
Just to say, like, he always appears in these scenes as an egg now because we've built this asset.
Yeah.
I don't know what level of dexterity, you know, the different hackers and coders have got, but, you know, if you're involved with this stuff and you want to, you know, shed some light on it, please let us know in the comments or get in touch on at GTAV oclock.
Yeah, we'd love to have you on, even to just talk about what your findings are and things like that. I think the thing to take away from it is the hunt continues. No one's found anything actually in the game yet without properly ripping it apart. We're scouring it every week for new things. We're always checking out new stuff. So if you do have any hints towards things that we might have to go and look at that we can feature on the show, let us know in the comments or get in touch with us. So that is this week's GTA 5 o'clock news. If you do like the show, hit the like button. And don't forget to subscribe. Dan, are you going to join us on Friday?
Barring another attack of illness, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So come and join us. Get involved in our social club cruise on the Rockstar Social Club site. And we'll be back on Friday at 4 p.m. GMT for the live stream.
Right here on our channel.
Right here on the channel, yep. You can view it on YouTube, hopefully. Fingers crossed the tech guys are sorting out the issues we had last week, and hopefully everything will be back running smoothly in time for Dan's return at 4 p.m. this Friday. If you can't make that, then join us again next week for the Wednesday show. We'll have more in-depth analysis from the world of GTA 5.